Data are nowadays everywhere, regardless where you look, and every field of science or industry generates data in a seemingly effortless manner. Examples are genomic measurements of patients, transactions of the stock market, or communication on social media. For this reason, data have been called the oil of the 21st century. To deal with this flood of data, a new field has been established, called data science. My name is Frank Emmert Streib, and I'm professor of data science at Tampere University, where I lead a predictive society and data analytics lab. The name data science appeared first in the 1970s, but it took until 2007, when in Shanghai the first research center for datalogy and data science has been established, where datalogy means science of data. Data science combines the skill sets and expert knowledge of many different fields, including machine learning, artificial intelligence, network science, and statistics. This makes the field inherently interdisciplinary because each of these fields has its own history. The availability of data provides opportunities in all fields of science to gain new information and to tackle difficult problems. However, data alone do not provide information. First, they need to be analyzed. This is what we call learning from data, which is at the heart of data science. In the following, I will address three questions that allow you to get some insights into data science. What data are studied by data science, current challenges of data science, and how to become a data scientist. There's a large number of quite different data types, and in the following, I will describe three data types in more detail that are studied in my lab. Specifically, I will describe gene expression data, text data, and network data. The first data type I will talk about is called gene expression data. Such data provide information from biological cells of animals or plants about the activity of genes by measuring the concentration of mRNAs. Humans have over 20,000 genes, which means that the resulting profiles obtained from such genomic experiments correspond to high-dimensional arrays of numbers. Using gene expression data does not only allow to learn about molecular biological laws, but also to gain a better understanding of diseases and to help developing treatments. The latter forms the basis of what is called personalized medicine. The second type I would like to mention is text data. Text data differ significantly from gene expression data because they are not presented as numerical values, but as symbol sequences composed of letters from an alphabet. That means before any analysis of text data can be conducted, a transformation or mapping of the symbol sequences to numbers needs to be performed. However, already this mapping is very challenging and no optimal solution currently exists. Still, examples like ChatGPT demonstrate impressively capabilities of modern deep learning methods. The third data type I will present is called network data. In general, networks called graphs provide an elegant way to present the connectivity among discrete units. Such discrete units are called nodes, and the connections between these are called edges or links. While the most simple network consists of only two nodes and one edge, the combination of many nodes and many edges can result in very complex networks. An example for such a network is the gene regulatory network of breast cancer. This network, inferred from data, is like a blueprint of a disease that shows a global dependency structure among the genes. In general, the interrogation of such networks allows to gain insights into the causal mechanisms that are present in disorders. From these examples, you see that data science needs to be very versatile by providing different analysis methods for the efficient analysis of many different data types. Despite the diversity of data and methods for the analysis, there is a common underlying thread describing the purpose of data science, and that is data science allows to make predictions. While this sounds simple, the challenge is to make systematic predictions by minimizing prediction errors. Here, statistical thinking is playing a key role to complement approaches from artificial intelligence and machine learning. My lab is working on two main themes for making predictions of societal relevance, which I will address in the following. These themes are learning paradigms of data science and network effects. A popular learning paradigm is supervised learning. An example for a method thereof is binary classification. While this learning paradigm is still useful, in recent years, a number of very different learning paradigms entered the stage. In particular, my lab works on transfer learning, multi-label classification, and the digital twin. The idea of transfer learning is to use two different but similar data types, one from a so-called source domain and the other from a target domain, which can form independent classification problems. Transfer learning utilizes parts of the model trained from the source domain for the target domain. This is very useful when a data from the target domain is very small and the data from the source domain is substantially larger. An example for such a model is ChatGPT, which uses transformer models that are based on transfer learning. My lab studies such question-answering systems to gain a better understanding of the information transfer as well as the evaluation of provided answers. Another learning paradigm that my lab is currently focusing on is multi-label classification. In contrast to ordinary classification, for multi-label classification, a model is allowed to predict more than one class label. My lab studies such models for electronic health records of patients because it is not uncommon for a patient to suffer from more than one illness. By improving the efficiency of multi-label classifications, thousands of electronic health records can be automatically explored to identify patterns which may inform a potential treatment. The last example for a learning paradigm I would like to mention is a digital twin. Put simply, a digital twin allows to simulate data that are indistinguishable from its real-world counterpart. An early example from engineering are simulation models for jet engines of airplanes. In contrast, my lab works on health-related digital twins to improve the treatment of patients suffering from AML, which is a form of blood cancer. This is an ongoing collaboration with the Institute for Systems Biology in Seattle and the University of Helsinki, jointly funded by the Academy of Finland and the National Institute of Health in the United States. The second main theme my lab focuses on is network effects. This is best understood when thinking about measuring a number of variables from a system, for example, the expression of genes. Since we know the genes are interacting with each other to establish a biological function, it is clear that such variables are not independent from each other. My lab studies two types of network effects, direct and indirect effects. For studying direct network effects, we first infer networks from data and perform then a structural analysis. This is related to a causal inference because the inferred networks should represent biological interactions among genes rather than their associations. In contrast, an example for an analysis based on indirect network effects is feature selection. While it would be desirable to identify a small number of features capable of explaining an observed outcome, the underlying networks controlling the connectivity among variables typically contain feedback loops leading to a high redundancy among the features. In general, this makes it very hard to identify unique feature combinations, which is a particular problem for the search of biomarkers in medical studies, but also for other fields that require explainable models. My lab studies not only the selection of biomarkers, but tries also to contribute to a better understanding of explainable artificial intelligence. If you are a student excited about analyzing data to gain a better understanding of medicine, economics, or the social sciences, you may wonder how to become a data scientist. Given the interdisciplinary nature of data science, you need to learn mathematics, including statistics and computer science, because programming skills are important for adapting or developing methods. Currently, Tampere University offers several master's degree programs in data science with a specific focus on machine learning, artificial intelligence, or statistics. Maybe the best outlook highlighting the career prospects in data science has been given by an article that appeared in the Harvard Business Review titled "Data Scientist, the Sexiest Job of the 21st Century." Considering the constant influx of data in combination with our progress in artificial intelligence will ensure that you are always at the forefront of science. Thank you for your interest.